It's Dr. Nancy, so good to see you. Okay, today we're gonna talk about what's behind your back pain, and it may not be what you think. Let's get started. Upper, lower, sciatica, wherever your back pain is striking you, well, it's important to understand that you are not alone. Nope, back pain is among the most common reasons people go to the doctor, their chiropractor, miss work, or lose out on some good REM sleep. Can you relate? It's not a laughing matter, and it's perhaps the number one reason people are paying out of pocket for relief, and also the leading cause of disability worldwide. What causes back pain? Because if we understand that, then we can nip it in the bud and prevent it from even ever being an issue, right? Well, causes are often misunderstood. And get this, we now know that the root causes, in many cases, are not just physical, but can also be emotional and mental as well. That's right, there can be a whole host of less obvious reasons behind back pain, making it really hard to pinpoint, but doing so is an important part in preventing back pain spasms from even ever occurring. In this video, you're gonna learn a few ways on how to take measures into your own hands and lower inflammation in your body so your back can get some relief. Now, perhaps one reason why your back is aching is plain anatomy, because the entire back makes up 18% of the body, and your chest and your front torso will makes up another 18%. Carry the one, yeah. That's over a third of your body, and having extra weight around your middle, especially being overweight, obese, and having poor posture hunched over on a screen like this, it can add pressure on the spine, which then adds to low back pain. But there are external influences as well that can wreak havoc on your back, and internal influences too that can also create problems. Yeah, it's a lot, I know. It's important to note that surgery is rarely needed to treat back pain. If you do experience back pain, then often simple home treatments and incorporating better body mechanics will get you on the right path to healing within a few weeks and keep you functional after that. There are simple measures that you can take to help prevent and alleviate most back pain, and we're gonna get into that. But first, a quick understanding of the most common symptoms of back pain. And they are muscle aches, shooting or stabbing pain, pain that radiates down your leg, pain that worsens with bending or lifting, standing or walking, pain that improves with reclining. It's also important to note that back pain that comes on all of a sudden, and then lasts more than 6 weeks, is what we call acute back pain, and is usually caused by a fall or heavy lifting. But chronic pain, this is what we're gonna focus on in this video, is way harder to address. Back pain that lasts more than 3 months, which is called chronic back pain, is less common than acute, and a few common conditions that can lead to chronic back pain, we're gonna talk about those. The first one, arthritis. Osteoarthritis can affect the lower back. In some cases, arthritis in the spine especially can lead to a narrowing of the space around the spinal cord, a condition called spinal stenosis. Another common condition that can lead to chronic back pain is skeletal irregularities, a condition in which your spine curves to the side, to one side or the other, called scoliosis, which can lead to back pain, but generally not until middle age. Osteoporosis is another one. Your spine's vertebra can develop compression fractures, okay? If your bones can become too porous or brittle, that is a huge problem as well. Muscle or ligament strain is another one caused by repeated heavy lifting or a sudden awkward movement, like checking your blind spot, and can strain back muscles and spinal ligaments as well. If you're in poor physical condition, constant strain on your back can cause painful muscle spasms. Last one, bulging or ruptured discs. Discs act as cushions between your bones and the spine. The soft material inside the disc can bulge or rupture and press on a nerve. However, it's important to note that you can have a bulging or ruptured disc without back pain. But if you have had it, it's no fun. If you do have any back problems and pain persists, and you do not see a gradual improvement with rest or home improvement treatments and self-care, then it's time to see your professional healthcare provider. In rare cases, back pain can signal a serious medical problem. It's especially important to see your doctor if you're experiencing back pain for the first time over the age of 45 or 50. If you have a history of cancer, osteoporosis, steroid use, or excessive drug or alcohol use. All right, enough with the disclaimers. Now let's talk about proper body mechanics. Now, proper body mechanics can help prevent and relieve back pain. You want to avoid movements that twist or strain your back. Occupational therapists and postural experts, well, they suggest that you stand, sit, and lift smart. That means stand smart. Don't slouch. Maintain a neutral pelvic position. If you must stand for long periods of time, place one foot on a low footstool to take some of the load off your lower back. And then you want to alternate your feet. Good posture can reduce the stress on your back muscles. Second one is to sit smart. Choose a seat with good low back support, armrests, and a swivel base. Place a lumbar pillow or a rolled up towel in a small little area right here on your back to maintain its natural curve and keep your knees and hips level. You want to change your position frequently, at least every half hour. Last one, lift smart. Avoid heavy lifting if possible, but if you must lift something heavy, let your legs do the work. Lift from your legs. Keep your back straight with no twisting and bend at the knees. Hold the load closer to your body. Find a lifting partner if the object is heavy or awkward. Here are some of my top tips for controlling and alleviating back pain. I'm just gonna glaze over a couple and you're gonna find so many more in-depth tips in my chronic pain guide. Now, holistic specialists tell us that if you work on addressing the following four things, then you can help keep your back healthy and strong with less frequent back pain flare-ups. Yes, we like that. Much of the actual pain is linked to, get this, inflammation, especially in cases like low back pain and sciatica. So you want to do everything you can to lower your daily inflammation in the body, including dietary changes and the right supplement support. I'm going to go over all of that in my chronic pain guide. First tip, build muscle strength and flexibility, abdominal and back muscle strength, right? You want to incorporate exercises which strengthen your core, help condition your muscles so that they all work together cohesively, kind of like a natural corset for your back. Flexibility in your hips and your upper legs is also very important as it aligns your pelvic bones and it will help your back feel much better. Second tip is to exercise, body movement. Very important. Regular low impact aerobic activities that don't strain or jolt your back, like biking or swimming, those are really good. It can really increase strength and endurance in your back and allow your muscles to function better. All right, I'm gonna throw in one more tip. Maintain a healthy diet and weight. You know, being overweight really does strain your back muscles. And if you are overweight, then it's paramount that you start to trim down to help prevent back pain. The best diet is gonna be the anti-inflammatory diet. You can get the details on how to eat the anti-inflammatory diet in my chronic pain guide. Next one, number four, lost track. Quit smoking and quit the alcohol. Smoking and pain are directly linked together. If you are still smoking, you want to talk to your doctor on ways to quit. Cutting down or eliminating alcohol is going to improve not only your back pain, but joint pain and other discomforts as well. It's also about controlling inflammation naturally through dietary changes, such as taking away, eliminating all the inflammatory foods. You want to incorporate healthy lifestyle changes. You want to manage stress better. You want to get in your daily body movement, exercise, and you want to take advantage of the best that natural science has to offer by promoting healthier inflammatory responses in the body. For an in-depth step-by-step exercise guide and video series on how to alleviate your back pain and strengthen and stretch those muscles, the tendons and the tissues all around your core and your back, I want to invite you to get Dr. Nancy's Chronic Pain Alleviation E-Guide available when you subscribe to my monthly membership. Thanks so much for watching. It's Dr. Nancy. I'll see you next time.